Yo, what's goody, guys? It's J Pluto here. I know it's been a minute, but I'm back with a new tutorial video, and I hope you guys can get the best out of this because this is a pretty dope video. I've been experimenting with this joint, this feature in FL Studio for a couple of days now, and I think it's something you guys can definitely grab onto and make some hot joints out of. All right, so let's get into it. Basically, we're talking about creatively sampling inside of FL Studio, and basically what we're going to be using is the FL Studio stem extractor, which is a part, which is the feature of FL Studio 21. So if you don't have FL Studio 21, go ahead and download that, upgrade your joint, I mean, and get that going. All right, so I'm gonna jump right into it. Basically, I got my sample pulled up, but I want to, like, I'm not really a chop sampler like that, but I want to make something creative to this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna break this down into parts, and then we're gonna recreate parts, and then we're gonna make our own renditions of this beat. I got my sample loaded up here. It's Drew Hill. Alright, so that's my sample. Yeah, just make sure this time is right. I like to go to auto. Sometimes I put Sample Pro, but I mean, it depends on the sound. Sometimes it be sounding weird to me. So basically, what you want to do, you want to go in here, click that, and go to extract stems from sample. Now, you might run into a problem with this, and I have the solution for you. Basically, if you're having the issue of downloading it, for the first time you use it, it's going to say you have to download something to make it work. Is going to download, and on the side it's going to say download it, and nothing is going to happen. It's going to keep telling you that you have to download this thing for it to work.
Bruh.
What you want to do is you want to go up into options, file settings, and then troubleshooting. This arrow might be like that. You want to click it, and you want to click on this repair optional features. After you click on that, you should be good to go with your stem extractor. All right, so once you go up in here, you're going to click that, gonna click extract stems from sample. So it's gonna give you these sounds, and basically if you want just the drums, you got the drums. I mean, you want the bass, you got the bass. I mean, you can make some new sample for that joint right there. I mean, change the sample, change the rate. I mean, throw that joint up like 3 cents, throw that joint back, throw that joint up 3 cents. I mean, now you already started switching things up. Now, I mean, you got the other things that say you just wanted the vocals from that joint. Bow. You could use that for another beat or something else. Now, I mean, you got the instruments. Now, the only thing I will say with this is that all the instruments are put together, so there is some more work that you have to put in until, I mean, this technology gets better. It just is what it is. Other than that, usually what I use is Layla AI, and it's pretty good. You get pretty clean isolated vocals and whatever sounds you want. I mean, you could do vocal instruments, drums, bass, voice, guitar, whatever. I mean, it's pretty dope. Yeah, definitely check that out too. But like I said, for the sake of this video, I only used FL stem extractor. All right, so after you have all of those things, what you can do is, let's say for this part, I just wanted the guitars or something. I mean, now I can go in and I can listen to specifically what the guitars is playing, and I can go into my piano roll and I can start trying to replay that or replay it on the keyboard. Now, that's exactly what I did and how I got to this point. My bad. I got to this point. So basically, like I said in the beginning, I went and I figured out how to play the sample. Let's see if I can. Alright, so I mean, and that's a pretty good redemption, if I say so myself. But basically, I did that. I felt that, I felt that because I used an acoustic guitar, I decided to use an electric guitar and scrap the acoustic guitar, though I have it playing in the background for some texture. So after I got that, I threw some effects on it, guitar rig and some reverb, guitar rig, creamy snowflakes. I made some alterations to it, and I threw some Valhalla reverb on it, and I consolidated it to this sample. That sounds beautiful. That sounds beautiful, if I might say so myself. All right. So after I had that, I also made a unique copy of this, and I pitched it down 12 cents. So basically, I just took it down an octave. All right. So, and that's basically through the whole beat. That's my guitar sample. It's that regular sample and then the down one octave sample. Outside of that, I also came up with a bass line from those. Well, this is actually my violin part. My bad. So this is my violin part. I pretty much threw that into the intro. Here's my bass line. And all of this is based off of recreating from those samples that I extracted, all right? So these, it's like a variation of the bass line, a variation of the strings that's in there. But I just put my own switch, my own change up on it, use different instruments and stuff like that. Also throwing a piano, it's pretty basic right now. This is still a work in progress. So I'm probably gonna go and throw a couple of extra more notes in there just to add some more movement. Pretty simple and straightforward. Besides that, I have some vocal samples. I also took the drums. Just have that as like a perky loop. Then I got the vocals here. That's really fire. That's fire. And I got a couple more vocal joints. I feel like just a little bit more, so I found this vocal joint. Joint. Put all those together, and that's my intro. So from the intro, it goes into the verse, and basically, as I stated before, I just took those guitars and I put it down 12 octaves, one octave, 12 cents, one octave, and I added some drums in here. Here's my drums. Pretty much, I replayed the same kick drum. I just used a more modern drum and just gave it a little bit more of a swing. After that, I came in with the 808 for this next part of the verse. Now, I was kind of conflicted with the bass because I do have parts of this beat that does have the original bass line, but it's kind of like a variation of it. So that's my 808s. I made a couple different variations of it just to switch it up for different parts of the beat. And also got the drums in here too, but I just filtered it out. Track 8. Yeah, I just filtered it out. And then we have this breakdown part where I used some of the original bass line, but I just switched it up a little bit just so, like I said, it doesn't become too repetitive for me. Also on this part, I added a pad on this second part that it comes in. analog lab pad. Same chords. Besides that, I mean, I just got a couple of transition sounds in there, a couple of sound effects, some chimes, transition joint. That's pretty much the bulk of it. I don't think I'm gonna add more to this, for the simple fact that it's already full. And I'm just, the only thing else I'm gonna do to it is like mix it up and clean it up and stuff like that. But for the most part, that's the joint. All right, so real quickly, I'm gonna show you the technique that I use to basically get these notes of what's being played in my samples that I'm sampling. All right, so for instance, I'm gonna use this pattern. Even though this is what I got from my sample, I'm gonna use it to show you how to use this technique. All right, so we have our guitar. Let's say that was the guitar part that I took from my stem extractor. That's my guitar part. Think of it as a sample. I'm gonna put it into its own channel. It's in channel 5 right now. So my channel, I'm going to open up Melodyne. Now you do need Melodyne to do this. Now you can do this in FL Studio, it has a built-in feature, but it is nothing like using Melodyne for this feature. Melodyne for this technique. You got it up there, make sure you hit transfer and you're gonna hit play. Now, the program is going to record your audio. From there, it's going to analyze the audio and then it's going to give you a MIDI of that audio. Now, from that MIDI, you take that MIDI and you figure out the exact keys that was played, or at its very least, the root note, and you can do anything that you want to do. I promise you. Hit that, it's gonna record. After it records, is going to give you a MIDI of it. It's also going to give you the keys of it. All right, so you can either take this information and use it. You now know what keys to play on the piano. You know what to use for the bass note when you're using your bass sound. I mean, you have all of that right here in front of you now. Next thing that you can do is to export. Go here to settings, save as MIDI. You save as MIDI, save it, and then you bring it back into FL Studio as a MIDI file, and now you have the MIDI of that sample. I'm not gonna hold you up. It is time consuming. It can be time consuming, let me say that. It can be time consuming, because it gives extra notes and things like that. So depending on the settings that you have in there, it could be giving you some extra notes that might be something in the percussion and stuff like that. So you really have to spend some time and some work figuring it out and getting the right sounds. Thank you for tuning in and checking out my video. I hope you guys got something out of this. Make sure you keep cooking up all positive vibes, and I'll see you guys next time. Yeah.